Are teleprompters dead? Have we finally reached the end of that bulky, expensive hardware that allows you to look directly into the camera and read a script, or just look someone in the eye on a video call? I've reviewed over a dozen teleprompters over the years looking for the perfect solution, and now AI may have made all of this unnecessary. You see, I'm not looking at the camera at all. I'm reading a script on my computer screen. It's about 3 inches below the camera, and artificial intelligence is realigning my eyes to make it look like I'm looking directly into the camera lens. There are a couple of drawbacks to this solution in 2023, but I'm sure this will improve in the next year or two. So let's talk about when you can ditch the teleprompter and when AI is all you need. First off, let's start with the biggest one. I haven't found a software that does this real time for your live streams or video calls. If you are recording your videos, you can use this system. But if you are talking live, like on a video call, you'll still need teleprompter hardware to be able to look the viewer in the eye. I'll bet that in 2024, we'll start seeing this happen in real time. Actually, there is one graphic card that can do it real time already, but most people aren't ready to open up their computer to switch out the graphic card, not to mention that that's not possible on a laptop. Second, the eye contact looks a little unnatural. You can see that I never ever look away from the camera, and that's something that you might do when you were using a physical teleprompter, but if you were good at it, then you'd glance away once in a while to make it feel less like you were staring into the viewer's soul. I predict that in 2024, the better software will be able to understand this and will allow you to look purposely off camera, and maybe even add in the perfect amount of glancing away to make the viewer feel comfortable. If your eyeline is really far off, like if your script is at the bottom of the screen or far off to one side, then the AI can struggle whenever you blink. You end up with one or two frames where your eyes are opening when you are still looking off camera. I'm sure that this will get better over time. Let's talk about the pros of this technology. First, it's easy for the person on camera. If you're reading a script, you can do that with just software like SpeakFlow, which is what I'm using here. And your camera can be where it normally is at the top of your screen. Before this tech, you either needed to memorize your script or use a teleprompter hardware to put your script in front of the camera. I still recommend that you keep your script relatively narrow and close to the camera. That gives the AI less work to do and the results tend to look better. Let me demonstrate. If your script is taking up the entire 30-inch screen, the AI has a lot of work to do to move your eyes back to the center, and that result is kind of jittery eyeballs. It's also easy if you're recording a video call. It allows the people on camera to look at the other person, which is very natural. They can get feedback like nods and smiles, so they have more confidence on camera. But remember, right now, it doesn't work with live video calls. There can be a downside for your video editor though. First, they'll be the one running this AI process, which takes a little bit of time. And I've also found that when I edit AI corrected footage, I need to go in and micro edit out those strange glitches that it can insert, like when someone blinks and their eyes move right before and right after they close. Okay, so how do you do this? Right now, I'm using Veed.io. Eye correction is part of the pro or above plans, so plan to pay $30 or more a month. However, for me, I also use Veed to create video closed captions, so I save money on Rev, and Veed is able to add the text on screen as someone is talking. It creates an Instagram-like video, which is more engaging. I'll often use this feature to create YouTube shorts or Facebook videos. But let me show you how Veed works for eyeline correction. Then I'll come back and tell you about one more online tool for correcting eyelines. So I use Final Cut Pro to do my editing, and you can see the project here. I have taken everything for this video and edited it so that it's on the timeline, and this has none of the eye correction in it. So I exported this file, and now I'm going to go over to Veed.io, and I'm logged in here, and I'm going to say that I'm going to create a new video, create project, and I'm going to choose that file. So this is the prefix. So you'll need to wait for it to upload for these tools to work, and then click on it here, go down to Magic Tools, Eye Contact. You can see some of the other things that they can do: remove the background, green screen, clean up some audio, translate the voice, cut out dead air and awkward pauses. So there's a number of things that it can do besides just correcting the eyeline. So we're going to sit back. It's going to take a few minutes for it to go through and correct the eyeline on this. It's almost about a 5-minute video at this point. Okay, so that's just a couple of minutes. You can see my eyes are looking directly at the camera. So we can go ahead and push play and see how well it did.
Our teleprompter's dead. Have we finally reached the end of that bulb?
So far, so good. Let's take a look over if we could turn it off right now.
The expensive hardware that allows you to look directly into the camera.
You can see the difference that it makes. Now, I mentioned earlier that I like to add the text on screen, so let me just show you how I do that. Just go to the subtitles and then do the auto subtitle. And then I like to just go ahead and create subtitles. And this will take a couple minutes. Okay, so that actually took probably less than a minute. And you can see here the subtitles and how they're displayed on the screen. And you can go through and merge subtitles together if you want to, if you've got a couple that are like really short ones. It highlights the words that it's not sure about. So yeah, I think what I'm gonna do is just go ahead and change the style here a little bit. We've got kind of examples across the top. So this is where it highlights it. Don't like that style. You can play around too with the fonts and things like that once you've got something somewhat the way you want it. Then you can take a look at how it works.
Or just look someone in the eye on a video call.
What I like is it will highlight the words, or there's a way you can say that it will reveal the words as you speak them. And you can change the exactly where they are, things like that. If there's a little break, you can give those things a fix. So when you are complete and you're ready to go and export this, you can click Done. And then you'll go through. I changed the quality standard up to, let's do HD. And you can decide whether or not you want those subtitles burned in. And for this one, I'm not going to burn them in. I'll burn them in then the next time that I go through and export this. And then when you're ready, click Export Video. What this is it is now on the vid.io website, ready to be shared. So what you need to do though is download it right now, typically. So let's go ahead and click the download button here. I can turn off those captions here. Well, let's download it here. And I'm going to download it as a MP4 video. And I'm going to call this postfix because it's been fixed now. So now what we'd end up doing is taking this back over to Final Cut and inserting it here. And make sure it's perfect.
I'm sure there are other.
It's maybe off by a quarter of a frame or something like that, but we're going to turn the volume off on that one. And now we can go through and mix this one in and make sure everything looks perfect, that there aren't any of those kind of strange spots where my eyes are looking the wrong direction. Hopefully you enjoyed this quick tutorial. Hopefully that will help you get on your way with vid.io. There is an affiliate link down in the description. I'd love it for if you purchase that. If you use that link, it helps to support my channel. My friend Dane uses Descript. This is actually an editing tool where you can edit from the script. If someone says, you can cut that out of the transcript and those frames disappear from the video. And you can take entire sentences and move them around. And they recently added AI Eyeline Correction. I'm sure there are other solutions, and if you know of one, please leave that in the comments below. Be sure to check the description for any potential affiliate links that support this channel. Thanks for watching and have a great day.